Online lecture series. Myself Prima Raval from Elgin Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication. I will be taking the online lecture series on the subject computer networks. So let's start today's session.
So first of all, what is networking? So in previous session we have seen the networking concept and uses of networking. So networking is basically the communication between different devices or different computers located in different locations using some platform, which is referred to as the networking. And they are used for some specific application or for some specific purpose. So let us consider the client-server model, which is important for this. That means in client-server model, there are two processes. The first one is the request and the second process is the response. That means whenever any device wants to communicate or wants to access the internet, it will send the request to the server, and in response to that request, the server will respond back, which is termed as the response to the device back via the network. So this is the way how a web page is accessed, which is referred to as the client-server model. So entire entity on this computer networks operates on this model, which is referred to as the client-server model. Now, let's see different network topologies. So first of all, what is topology? So topology is basically an arrangement, or you can say how we can connect to the network, the typical arrangement for that. So we can say that network topology is defined as the geometrical representation of relationship between links and nodes. That means how it can connect to the different devices in that network. So there are various topologies in the networking. And in this session, we are going to study the basic six networking topologies. In this, the first topology is the bus topology. The second topology is the ring topology. The third one we are going to see is star topology. The next topology is tree topology. Then the next is mesh topology. And the last we are going to see is the hybrid topology. So let's start with the first one, which is bus topology. So as you can see in this bus topology, there is only single cable through which all the devices are connected. So that's why it is called as the bus topology. Then the next topology over here is the ring topology. So as you can see, it is formed in the shape of the ring. That means all the devices are connected in a way that it forms the shape of the ring. That's why it is referred to as the ring topology. Then the next one is star topology. In star topology, there is a central device through which all the devices are connected. That's why it is forming a star shape. That's why it is named as the star topology. The next topology over here is the mesh topology. In mesh topology, all the devices are connected to each of the nodes or each of the devices connected in that particular network. The next is tree topology. It is forming the shape of the tree. That means it will have the branches and sub-branches. That's why it is called as the tree topology. And the next one is hybrid topology. As the name suggests, it is a combination of two or more devices or two or more arrangements of the different topologies. That's why it is called as the hybrid topology. So let's start with the first one, which is bus topology. Here, the bus topology diagram is shown to you. As you can see, this is the backbone cable. That means there is a single cable using which all the devices are connected to each other. The main drawback of this topology is that If the backbone cable or the cable through which all the devices are connected fails, then all the segment fails and they are failed to interconnect. So in this, the cable to which the nodes connect is called as the backbone. And if the backbone is broken, the entire segment fails. So now the next is ring topology. As you can see over here, this is the ring topology shown. In this, all the devices are connected forming the ring shape. So each device is connected to two different devices. And in this, the data is transferred using a round robin algorithm. So this will pass the token and token management is done to send the data. The next over here is star topology. In star topology, as you can see over here, there is a central device through which all the other devices are connected, which is referred to as the hub sometimes. And to transfer the data, then central device has to transfer the all the connected devices. So, a star topology is a topology for a local area network in which all nodes are individually connected to a central point like hub or switch. The next is tree topology. As you can see over here, the main node is there, that is first central device, and through which other devices connected like the branches of the tree. So, a tree topology is a special type of structure in which many connected elements are arranged like the branches of a tree. Now, the next is mesh topology. As the name suggests, it shapes like a mesh. That means in this, all the devices are connected to every devices in that particular network. That means there is no such central device in this. So as you can see over here, this computer is connected to other computers in the networks, right? So, mesh topology is a special type of networking where all nodes cooperate to distribute data amongst each other. And the next is hybrid topology. This is the collection of two or more different topologies. Over here, you can see there is a collection of star topology and the linking topology, right? So a hybrid topology is a type of network topology that uses two or more different networking topologies. Now let us see the next concept, which is classification of network by scale, by area, or by geographical region covered. So that means, let's say for example, if you want to communicate with your friend, with your relatives, and even across the globe, then you will be categorized according to your geographical region. So there are generally four classifications of this, and also we are going to consider the broad classification of this as well. So over here, the first one is PAN, which is referred to as the personal area network. This is covering approximate distance of 1 meter. Let's say for example, wireless mouse, wireless printers, or you can say Bluetooth devices, okay? Now the second is LAN, which is referred to as the local area network. This covers the approximate distance from 10 meters to 1 kilometer. For example, a room, a building, or a campus. The third classification is MAN, which is referred to as the metropolitan area network. This covers the approximate distance up to 10 kilometers. Let's say, for example, a city. Then the fourth classification is WAN, which is wide area network. This covers the approximate distance of 100 kilometers to 1000 kilometers. Let's say, for example, to cover a country or a continent. And the last and broad classification, or you can say general classification, is the internet, which is distance of up to 10,000 kilometers. Let's say, for example, the entire planet. That means it covers the entire planet, right? Let us see each of this classification in detail. So, first one is PAN, which is personal area network. So, let's say, for example, if you want to communicate to your mobile device, your wireless printer, or headset device that are wireless, then the distance covering in this much distance is come under the category of personal area network. And for wider distances, we have to move to the next category, that is LAN, local area network. So let's say, for example, in some college campus or in some other campus, there are some buildings in that particular campuses. And the devices who wants to communicate, they are on these two separate buildings. So they can communicate using the LAN cables. Also, in the same building, if the two devices who wants to communicate or who wants to transfer the data are on the different floors, if they want to transfer the data, they can also do this using the LAN cables. So the LAN cables or the LAN networks are the classifications in which you can transfer the data in the campus or in the particular building. Okay. The third one is MAN, which is Metropolitan Area Network. So the Metropolitan Area Network generally covers a city. So in a particular city, if there is some school, there is some factory, there is some train station or malls or any skyscrapers or any such buildings who wants to transfer the data in that particular devices, that comes under the category of MAN. That means this covers a particular city region. Then this referred to as the cable television networks that were previously used. It is similar to that. The next one is WAN, which is Wide Area Network. This generally covers a particular city and a country and a continent. That means that is the range up to the country, right? So anywhere across the country, there are some devices located in different cities or different zones. That comes under the category of Wide Area Networking. And the last and the broad classification is the Internet, which covers the entire planet. That means anywhere across the globe, anywhere on the planet, if you want to communicate to anyone, you can communicate using the Internet platform, which is very important nowadays. Okay? So I hope this is clear to you now. Two topics which are most important or which are the basis of the networking. The first one is the network topologies, or you can say arrangement. In that we have seen different topologies like ring topology, star topology, bus topology, hybrid topology, tree topology, etc. And then we have seen the classification of the network according to geographical region, according to the area covered. There are main four classification and the fifth one broad classification, internet. Okay? These are the references. Thank you. Thank you for listening.